Hello, everyone, and welcome to the fourth floor of the Victor Philip Tadali building. My name is Loris Dotto, and I'm one of two technicians here in the Department of Design. Today, I'd like to take you for a quick tour of the facilities that we have available for you here at York University. So let's get started by taking a walk down the hall here, and we can see in the display cabinets a variety of student work that's on display throughout the year. As we make our way down to the first undergraduate studio, we see some poster work, and then down here some work in typography that is printed on our risograph printer, and other student work down here at the end. So here we have the blue studio. As you can see, we have blue walls and blue chairs matching the theme that we're talking about here. And as you can see, 24 workstations, all Mac machines. Up at the front of the classroom is a podium for which the instructors can teach from. There's a speaker system, audio, a video projector on the ceiling with a screen on the wall over there. And then over here in the back of the room, we have black and white printers, so students can do black and white output in each of the studio spaces. Also here through the door behind the window there is my colleague's Rich's office, and his office adjoins both the blue studio and the green studio, which we'll get to in a sec. Let's just walk down the hall a little bit here. Before we get to the green studio, I want to enter into this space here, which is just outside of Rich's office. And here we have our photography studio. And in the photography studio, we can see here we have some lighting equipment suspended from the ceiling, some backdrops on the back wall, and a variety of other photographic equipment that we can use to take pictures of three-dimensional objects, books, and the likes. Some of the work that's done in here by students include video shooting, portrait work, project photos, and creation of content for other projects in courses like time-based media. So let's head on out the hallway here once again and into the middle studio, which is the green studio. And you can see here we have green walls, green chairs, and again, similar layout with 24 workstations and a teaching podium, black and white printers in the back corner of this room as well. So let's make our way out down the hall to our third and final studio. And you can see down at the end of the hall, we have a very large video projection system where we can project student work that's created in time-based media or interactive work that can be displayed on that screen as well. And once again, here we have again more print-related output from various classes and courses in the program. Before we go into the last studio, we're gonna take a little turn here into this space, which is just outside of my office, which is found back there. But this space here is the Design Student Association room. We call it the DSA room. It's a place where students can hang out a little bit. You can see a microwave, a kettle, and toaster oven in the corner there, refrigerator under the black and white printer. But there's also space here for students to sit down and work between classes when the classrooms aren't available to work in. So they can sit down with their laptops here. We have power. There's another Mac back there that you can print from. We also have a large bank of storage cabinets here where we have a lot of our paper supplies, and over here as well the shelves in which the bins are situated where student work is returned after being graded by the course instructors. So let's move on through this door and directly into the red studio. And as you can see, red walls and red chairs. Now this studio is in the midst of a little bit of an upgrade. We're looking to remove some of this table and seating here and bring in some more flexible seating to make this a more flexible teaching space. And once again, we have a podium here up at the front where the instructors will teach from. We have speakers, a screen, and a video projector on the ceiling. All right, let's make our way out and back into the hall once again. And we'll make our way down the hall here, and we can take a look at some more print-based work in the display cases along studio three or studio one, as well as our cabinet here for three-dimensional work. So this is work that's primarily done in 3D design or package design, primarily package design one and two. And you can see a wide variety of materials are being used, various techniques in terms of printing, as well as in this case, this project was laser cut, laser etched, and using a wide variety of the tools in the Fab Lab. The Fab Lab is situated just down the end of the hall there, through those doors. But before we go in there, we'll talk about what's going on over here on the video projection wall. So we use this as a space to present student work that's done, in this case, what you see on the screen right now, some interactive work, as well as time-based media projects that are produced in that course. Down the end of the hall here, we have the MDES studio, the Master Design Program studio. And through there, the master students have their workspaces as well as a lecture space in there as well. And then through this main door here, we have the offices for all of the faculty members as well as our administrative staff, where when you go through reception, you'll see Judy at the front desk, Antonia, the program assistant, Barbara, admin, and Andrea, the graduate program assistant. So now we've made our way into the Fab Lab, and this is where all the magic happens, and we can see a wide variety of equipment all surrounding the room here. Now let's start off in this corner, and we talked about the risograph machine here. This is a two-color risograph machine, and we can print two colors at once, and it simulates more of a print press kind of process as opposed to what we've typically see as output nowadays in the form of a color laser printer, which we can see here. This produces all of the work that you see that's anywhere from 8.5 by 11 to 1117 output. A lot of output from this printer here. We have a workstation here for the student monitors that help out and run the Fab Lab in the evenings and weekends, as well as around this side here, a variety of wide format printers. This particular Epson and the one behind it is capable of printing up to 44 inches wide on rolls of paper, approximately 100 feet long. So we can get some fairly big output from this kind of a printer. We have a smaller version of that printer over here, 17 inch wide Epson, which uses the same inks and can be used to produce smaller output that matches or mimics what is available in the larger unit. Here we have a Roland vinyl printer, which allows us to print on various substrates, substrates that include self-adhesive vinyl, perforated vinyl, window film, as well as heat transferable vinyl that we can use to take artwork, print it, cut it, and then apply it with the heat press that we have over in this corner to fabrics and garments and things like that. So we can use that as a secondary process, applying heat press to bring artwork onto various other fabrics and textiles. Also in this corner over here, we've got some bookbinding equipment. We have an electric guillotine for trimming and finish work, a drill press in the corner over here for drilling holes so you can hand stitch books and hand bind them. We also have some other binding equipment like a perfect binding machine here, some saddle stitch staplers, a coil binding machine, and a Surlox binding machine. Over here in this corner, you will find probably the machine that's used the most in the Fab Lab, which is our laser cutter. The laser cutter is used to etch or cut a variety of different materials, including paper, cardboard, wood, plexiglass. We can etch anodized aluminum. We can also insert a rotary device that will allow us to etch on cylindrical objects like bottles and glassware and things like that. We've also had the experimentation of doing things, etching on things like fruit, for example. It'll also work well with leathers and natural fabrics as well. So an interesting tool. One of the most recent additions to our Fab Lab is the Wazer water jet, and this device uses high pressure water and abrasive to cut through materials that we can't process on the laser cutter. Some of those examples include this piece of aluminum here that was cut to make a bottle opener, and it was cut through an 1/8 inch thick piece of aluminum. We can also cut stone, glass, ceramic tile, and a number of other metal substrates. So this is quite a new tool in the Fab Lab, and we're looking forward to seeing what kind of project students will be doing with this machine. We also have a space in the Fab Lab where students can sit down with their laptops, and there's electrical overhead so that they can plug in. When they're not in class and they can congregate here, there's some seating areas so that students can, you know, work together, collaborate on projects, things like that, outside of the actual class time, and continue working throughout the day. We also provide a couple of workstations in the corner over here so that if you need to do any output to the Fab Lab, you can sit down right here at these workstations and print directly to the work to the printers that are in this room. Over on this side of the room in the middle, we have a very large assembly table with a wide cutter, which is used to cut a lot of the output that comes from the wide format printers that we have back over here. One other piece of equipment that I want to talk about is this vacuum forming press that is found here in the corner. And what that was, it was a Kickstarter project that we funded a while back and got one of the very first models of this vacuum forming machine. What this allows us to do is take a sheet of very thin plastic, heat it, and form it with a vacuum around an object that we can use then as the basis for the shape, for the form. That form, that plastic form, can then become a mold for, you know, a variety of different materials like chocolate or soap or wax, candles, you know, a number of different things. Students have often used the vacuum former to create parts or pieces of some of their packaging projects as well. So that more or less covers what we have here in the Fab Lab, and that's where I want to end our tour today.